House of sorrow, fools in the house of mirth. No power on earth can make you wise. If you can't see the sorrow in his eyes, wise hearts dwell in a house of mourning. Fools fill their hearts with mirth. In fashion's frills, they earn their worth. Until returning to the cold, drab earth. Society's crumbling structure, you won't survive the fall. When you're stuck, you're going to end it all. Going to end it when you've spent it all. From the right kind of family tree. The best get more cream than the rest can dream of.
The toy a tighter corset, please.
Still and all, you must be willing to squeeze. Squeeze the sweat from farmers and miners, flee the stench of the steel and the oil refiners. Fleece the rent from tenement dwellers,
while floating far off from the buyers and sellers.
Our mothers and fathers taught us that. God forbids we should tinker or trade to contaminate the purity of our Easter parade. Our fathers and mothers taught us sweat was for others on the labor of the lesser. Our fortunes are made. Milliner, shield the lady's eye with an even bigger hat.
Grand Central Station, the hub of the nation. You get on here and can step off almost anywhere. You step on here, take a ride and get off where you always wished you could go. You're gonna go where you want. You're gonna be who you choose.
You're gonna do what you can to make sure you win and not lose.
You buy a ticket and hop on board, and the whirling world is your reward. The quiz is by and speeds along beneath your feet.
Oh, what an age in which to be alive. In this year of grace in 1905, find your place not only to survive, but thrive.
With the McKinley shot, then what we've got is a precedent who's evidently destined to shake up the status quo.
A progressive future surely looking swell to Roosevelt.
Teddy speaks softly and carries a big stick, a stick to make rich moguls sick. Now they have to pay for having everything their own fat way.
These are the days it pays to be alive. For the human race in 1905, it's a chase where anyone can win the prize.
Edison, electrifying.
Wilbur Wright, death-defying.
The Model B, as designed by Henry Ford.
So even Rockefeller could afford it.
Electric Collins, opening up the town suburban workers, mowing the farmers down, and if the city's jostling crowds, impossible
to see. Interborough rapid transit underground. Zeppelin's built his big gas back balloon.
Melody's magic takes us to the moon.
The friendliness in a matograph repairs a hit and run who's cut in half.
Caruso singing on the phonograph.
Transatlantic liners cut their time in half to get you sooner back from Gay Paris.
To parade your latest chic shopping spree.
While down below deck stowed in steerage are those huddled masses heading here, adjusting to the truth of all the lies they're told of streets not even gilded, much less gold.
From every port around the globe they come with bundles bound with hope to take the jobs Americans used to do. A working man can now choose not to do.
In factory, mine, and orchard, these immigrants won't mind the torture of the daily grind of dingy labor beside those who may be disinclined to love their neighbor.
Push and shove and slave and work to prove these new Americans will never shirk. They now can be depended on to do what old Americans no longer want to do.
So far, the 20th century only proves that all of the world is now on the move. So this must be the American century, who e'er an American be. With all for one and one for all, you might get workers to unite.
Who I want, I'm gonna go where I please. No one can tell me I can't fight to be free, because these are the days my happiness arrives. In this golden year of 1905, live with all the loveliness I can contrive. This is the year I can't afford to waste. They'll be awestruck by my exquisite taste, and a brilliant bridegroom will excuse my haste. Carefully I'll choose my path and calculate to cool the wrath of furies who deem all allure impure. Rich bachelors like Percy Gryce prefer their fiancés naive and nice. The secret to this affair is my appearing that I do not care, and pursue as long as the illusion be the praise not them but me. I'm afraid it is a kind of war, the combat I've been armor-plated for. The age-old battle's only charm is this, that marriage is the armistice.
So with the whole world knocking at our door, there is no more war worth the fighting for. In a century, Americans can say, no more to war. This is the century we will live to see. Plenty, peace, and prosperity, universal understanding and unity. Of peace and joy, of peace and joy and love.
Mr. Selden, what good luck.
Bachelors in fashion this year, but then I shouldn't tell you. You wouldn't believe me. In weaving your net, I have been caught in your snare. Am I that stupid? Captured by you. I'm out of your orbit. You couldn't afford it to marry a man who's not part of your plan. But if I say, my dear Miss Bart, how lovely you're looking today. You have stolen my heart. Run away with me from this quandary the world puts a miss in. The world wouldn't listen, so why? What if I say that gilded cage has one little door you can fly through? Just risk being poor when the world laughs upon your behalf. Then what good would it do? Tell you how much I adore you. A fortune made for you is all that I lack. No high finance hero. My credit is zero in the keen calculation you make in your simplest act. Your business is marriage, your exquisite carriage, from your porcelain fingertips to the gold in your hair. Though the future seems futile, your material's so fine, the proof of God's cruelty is in your design. Why settle for less when the best is on show? answer is no.
Winter's on Fifth Avenue and summer's on Capri, with my mama and dear papa sharing the best in things they loved me. Whirling round the continent in elegance and luxury, that atmosphere's my element. It's made a rare bird of me. Of course, the charm of our New York's the best of people know you. The promenading in the park, the brilliant ballroom show you. The glory of the opera, the glittering soap season. Mr. Gryce, don't you agree then?
My mother tells me so, or else I'd never go anywhere.
She's a beauty, no denying. Why, love, she could woo me without dryness. A girl so nice might strike my mama as a brand new Gryce.
Mother tells me to, or else I'd never do anything.
When you found me, 'Twas there for all to see that you'd be running from my love all your
Although my name is Rosedale, they call me the Levantine. Now what the hell does that mean when what they mean's a Jew? But one they find convenient, gentlemen who place their bets when they cannot pay their debts. See Rosedale. Ladies hoping for advice when investing's not quite nice, ask Rosedale. I tell them I'm not out to sell them if they will enable my seat at the table with an invitation. They talk about my people, they rant about my race, they spit their words like poison, but not into my face. They think that they're so different. So, if you ask Simon Rosedale, who's laughing that last laugh, we'd best get down to business and ask my better half. That is, if you will have me watch the other wives turn green. You'll wear diamonds like a queen, Mrs. Rosedale. Wanting money makes you wince. Making millions made a prince. of Rosedale. I'll need it. Suppose they'll concede it. I'll woo her and win her for weekends and dinners. She's my invitation.
Wings
words that I hear are not death drawing near, but the fury of scandal's tongue. Brace for the worst, hope for the best. It won't be the first time they've paid for the rest.
If you're lucky,
thanking me, I don't want to be thanked. You know, Lily, those checks you're banking from me, you deserve to be spanked. You're so chilly to me, it's time to collect. That's something men expect when girls aren't circumspect. So what do you say?
They say that Lily's been bought by money from Gus. You know, Lily has never really been thought of as one of us. Oh no, not really. It's not just that she can't be trusted by a nice young man like Percy Gryce, which somehow he knows.
I know I was a fool to put such blind trust in finances finagled by our friend Gus. If it's not mine, I swear I'll pay back every dime. My reputation's running out of time.
If time is money in this game you're playing, this loan will lose you more than ever you may win.
May I cut in?
Of course.
I can't believe that you're waltzing here in my arms. You know, Miss Lily, that it's perceived by the parties part of your charm to show it's finally time to pay for the crime of looking so divine by saying you'll be mine. So what do you
say? I'm dreaming, but I'm afraid that I can't. You know, our Lily's a scamp for scheming, but to them, that impossible man, de trop. Poor silly girl, twirling the floor with that party crashing bore, that upstart, who the hell do they think they are?
You asked me once to help you, and I do it the only way I can, by loving you.
Oh, love me, but please don't tell me so. I can't say yes, but it's so sweet to know. I won't be like my mother,
just a headstrong wife whose love dies from the living of the wrong life.
Then have your own way.
Then in turn, with her last breath, she said, her only dread, the only real unhappiness, is unforgivable shabbiness. And then Papa was ruined. And then Papa, he died, leaving Mama one daughter, unfit to be a bride. Mama was fit to be tied. With your face, she'd no idea how easily one slips into disgrace. One fatal miscalculation in her dreadful determination to marry me to, it didn't matter who, to be some fabulously wealthy man's wife. Mama's defeat is now complete. Look in the mirror, please, and tell me you don't see what I see. Younger, plainer, richer cousins debut each season, married by dozens. If I knew where I put it, I might know where to start. If I knew where she kept it, I'd look into my heart. Years ago, she tore it apart. Dingy. Sufficiency is nowhere near plenty, and now here I am, 29. Still, Miss Bart. Face, Mama, my face. Face, Mama, my face.
Thank you.
ones who knew me then would never recognize the shabby and despised Lily.
Down in this part of town, nowhere to go but down, the point of no return. Rooms where nothing ever blooms, down sordid smelling halls with dingy painted walls of flowers quaintly made. Flowers whose beauties faintly fade.
Past ten, this will be the last then. All these letters pay debts. Of the lily they all find it's kinder to forget. Right now, I've got to decide how to do it quickly. Just enough to die and not be left bereft and sickly. Tiny but warm and brown, I tip you. Drink you down. I love the feeling sweet and sure. A love whose motives always pure.
I love you, Lily.
Tiny bug. Tip you up and drink you down, and no. Now I know the truth. I've wasted all my youth in fear of being poor. In my quest to marry well, I made a kind of hell. That's all I know I can be sure of. Now, it's time to go. I've paid the debts I owe. No need to say goodbye. Why prolong a life of grief, when it is my belief that win or lose we die and die alone.
Down in this part of town, nowhere to go but down, the point of no return. Rooms where nothing ever blooms, down sordid smelling halls with dingy faded walls of flowers quaintly made. Flowers whose beauty faintly fade.
Lie down, watch the flowers waltz round. No time for a nightgown. Hope whoever finds my body be kindly. No pain, sleeping in a soft rain, drifting off away from all I ever was and never shall be seen to be
frills, they earn their worth. They don't deserve us. It's us they should thank. We showed them how beautiful life could be if all of them were as splendid as we.
Growing older is the most interesting thing that ever happened to me. I wasted my youth trying to be beautiful, but now that I've given up all hope, I feel far more free.
Thank you.